Come, it's Charmin. We heard you shouldn't talk about going to the bathroom in public, so we decided to sing about it.
Of my house painted, and I'm starting to notice that some spots are peeling and fading. It's going to happen after several New England winters. That means it's time to call CertaPro Painters. It's Kristen. I know CertaPro is going to do a great job. I've hired them many times to paint both the inside and outside of my home. These guys are right in your neighborhood. Each CertaPro Painters business is independently owned and operated. Now is the time to book that exterior painting job. Call CertaPro Painters at 1-800-GO-CERTA. That's CERTA with a C. 1-800-G-O-C-E-R-T-A. CertaPro Painters. We do painting. You do life.
Where's the best burger in town? Casey's Classic Burger Bar. Half-pound burgers, never frozen, and cooked fresh the way you like it. Great sandwiches and a full bar with spiked milkshakes. Casey's in Seekonk and North Attleboro. I'm Katie Cerrone, and you've never had a burger like this. Overheard at the...
And black and white comforter?
Oh, no.
Yellow shoes and black and...
Feel the same way about you all being out there. If I didn't have this to come to every day, I'd be going nuts like the rest of you are.
Well, I've been listening to you since 1992. So
it's almost
without rush every day is crazy.
Well, it's almost, you're almost a lifer. I really appreciate it.
Well, you're welcome. You're welcome. And good luck on your treatment next week. My point I wanted to bring up is the entire panic and the insanity going on right now reminds me of the media-driven hysteria over Y2K.
Yeah, you know, that is interesting comparison. The bottom was going to fall out of white. Airplanes were going to fall out of the sky.
Oh, bunkers were being built.
Satellites were going to fall on our heads.
Exactly. And, you know, I mean, people were building bunkers, and it ended up costing the United States $100 billion. And this just is very reminiscent to what's going on right now.
Yeah, and it turned out to be nothing.
Exactly.
But it was filled with all kinds of lead-up panic. And this is what media has become. Yeah, that's understandable, since media is competitive. But it's just irresponsible. I don't know how you put a lid back on it. I mean, the antidote for this is a more informed and educated population. And the media then is in the middle of that too, standing in the way of that. But I appreciate, Susan, thank you very much. Sean in Ogden, Utah, great to have you on the EIB Network. Hello.
Hello, Mega 24/7, dittos and prayers, Rush.
Thank you, sir.
So, you know, I'm no highly trained or skilled broadcast engineer or broadcaster, but I'm not going to tell you how to do your show, but it might be time to repurpose the America Held Hostage.
Why? I mean, that was created to deal with the election of Slick Willie. Wait, did I
like,
say erection of election of Bill Clinton?
This feels like with the coronavirus that we are being held hostage.
Oh, by the media, yeah. I understand. Look, it's frustrating. It is. I know how frustrating it is. In fact, folks, I got to tell you something. I'm not complaining. Every day is kind of like this to me. I mean, this is the extreme of it. But what do we do here every day? Every day we go against the grain. Every day we dispute the conventional wisdom and what everybody else is conforming to or with in the media. And, of course, it is Trump bad, Republicans suck, Republicans don't care, Republicans... We push back against it every day. And what is the evidence that it works every day? Well, Trump wins elections, Republican wins elections, so forth. But we don't see the evidence that pushing back against this, we don't see the evidence yet that reason is triumphing here. And nobody wants to be part of a panic. Nobody, that's to me really the bottom line to all this, is that nobody wants any of this to be happening. And yet, look at all the people reveling in it. The health professionals are reveling in it. They're loving the media time they get. They love going on TV, some of them, and ripping into Trump and Pence as they don't know what they're doing. Others love just the face time on media. People are people. And most people love being on TV. And the more they're on TV, the bigger star they think they are. And if they're on TV because they say certain things, then they got to keep saying certain things for TV to keep wanting them back. So if TV wants you to come on and explain to people how they're going to die next week, or how they might die next month, or how they're going to be lucky if they don't die this year, then you better keep telling people that, or TV's not going to want you back. If you ever go on TV and say, look, this, you guys are overblowing this. This is not as bad as TV's not going to ask you back. So you tailor what you're saying to being asked, but everybody wants to be on TV. And all it takes is being on TV two or three times and you think you're a star. You're on TV two or three times and you think everybody recognizes you. In fact, if you know how to watch people who are on TV, it's actually kind of funny. Because people on TV a lot are some of the most self-conscious people you've ever seen. And when you see them in public, they're just waiting to be recognized. I mean, they'll go to baggage claim and stand there with no bags, are being disgorged by the carousel. Or they will act like they get mad that you recognize them, like you're invading their privacy, when they're putting themselves in places to be recognized. It's almost not a mental illness, but it does things to people, especially when they think they're becoming famous. And if the fame is because of either being on TV or saying